Hello everyone. In this video, I will show you how to export an RDL report in a Blazor Server application using the Bold Reports Report Writer. The Report Writer is a class library that lets users export reports defined in RDL format as PDF, Word, Excel, or CSV documents. It is mainly used to export reports without previewing them. Make sure that your development environment has Visual Studio 2022 with ASP.NET and web development workloads. .NET 6.0 framework. First, let me show you how to create a Blazor Server application. Open Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a new project. I choose Blazor Server app and then click Next. If this template is not available, refer to the link in the video description to configure the system environment. Change the project name to Blazor RDL Report Writer and click Next. Then, choose the target framework as .NET 6.0 and click Create. You will see the default Blazor Server application created. Next, let me install the necessary NuGet packages in the application. In the Solution Explorer tab, right-click the project and choose Manage NuGet Packages. In the Browse tab, search for the boldreports.net.core package and install it in the application. The dependent packages will be installed automatically upon installing the boldreports.net.core package. Next, I create a folder named Resources in the www root folder of my application. This is where all the RDL reports are stored. For this video, I am going to add the sales-order-detail.rdl file to the Resources folder. You will find the sales-order-detail.rdl file's downloadable link in this video's description. Next, I need to add the API method to generate the exported document. For that, create a file named boldreportwritercontroller.cs in the data folder. In that file, include all the necessary using statements for referencing in classes and namespaces defined within these namespaces. Then set the root attribute for the Bold Report Writer Controller. Use the iHosting environment interface by importing the Microsoft.ASP.NET Core.Hosting namespace and injecting the interface through dependency injection to read the report file from the application. Next, I add the export method to export the report using the HTTP GET action. In the export method, I am going to read the report file as a stream and use it with the report writer. To do that, first I create a variable named report path and assign the path value that has the reports. Next, create an instance for the file stream using the report path. Then, create the memory stream to copy the value from the file stream to use it with the report writer. This copy process will be helpful to avoid file access problems in the server when running the application. Then, I create an object for the Bold Report Writer and create a variable to store the file name, file type, and export format for the exported file. Then, copy this code from the documentation and paste it in the export method. It determines the file format for saving the sales order details report and sets corresponding values for the file name, type, and format based on the chosen format. Next, load the report stream to the writer. I export the report to the stream using reportwriter.save and pass the file format that needs to be generated by the writer. Next, assign 0 as the value of the memory stream.position to read the file properly. Next, create a file stream result with an exported file memory stream to get the document on the client side. I assign a file name to the file stream result.file download name to be used for downloading. Now the exported file is generated. Now, I move on to the implementation of client-side API. Here, I am going to add an option to select the export file type and a generate button to get documents based on the selection of the export type. First, I open the host.cshtml file from the pages folder and add the necessary scripts. Inside the script tag, add the download file method to get the format and set the browser's location to the API endpoint api/bold-report-writer/export with a query parameter specifying the writer format. This action triggers the browser to download a file in the specified format from the export API added in the bold report writer controller file. Then, copy this code from the documentation and paste it in the script tag. This function retrieves the selected format type and returns it as a string. Then I open the index.razor file from the pages folder. Add the code to inject IJS runtime and invoke this JavaScript interop in the index.razor file. Copy the code with that selection option and the generate button from the documentation and paste it in the index.razor file. Inside it code, I add the PDF report method. This code asynchronously triggers the client-side JavaScript method download file to initiate the file download. Next, open the program.cs file and invoke the app.map controllers to map routes and actions, allowing the application to respond to HTTP requests made to controllers. Next, register the license token to remove the license validation message. In this demo, I am going to use the online license token. License tokens can be generated from the subscription section of the Bold Reports Accounts page. In the program.cs file, enter the code snippet to register the license token. I have provided a link to the video on registering a license using online license tokens and offline license keys in this video's description. Now, everything is ready to load the report writer. I build and run the application. You will see the option to select the export file type and the generate button. By clicking the generate button, the report will be exported in PDF format. When the downloaded file is opened, you will see the report in PDF. If you want the report in Word format, select that option and then click the generate button. You will see the report exported and the downloaded file in Word format. In this demo, you saw how to create a Blazor server application and configure it server-side and client-side to export a report using the Bold Reports report writer. I have provided a documentation link in the description below for the steps that were followed in this video. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.